Hi, and welcome back to The Shtick. We're now ending the show with a guest who suddenly popped out of nowhere. His name is Dr. Doodie Ringelblum. Hello, Doodie.
Hi, Henry. How are you?
I'm pretty good, yeah. We're always running with the wolves, you know. It's really like that on The Shtick. But it's really nice to see you on screen.
It's nice to see you too. We're all locked down so much that any familiar but infrequent face is a pleasure to look at.
What we wanted to essentially talk about is SKIF, firstly, is their 70th anniversary. And it was founded by two gentlemen in 1950, and one of them happens to be your father, Pinya.
That's correct.
And the other one was Simcha Burstin.
Absolutely correct. Good friends.
Tell us a bit about SKIF.
Well, as you say, SKIF was founded 70 years ago, the youth group of the Bund. SKIF actually is much older than 70 years, over 100 years old, having started in Poland well before the Second World War. And Simcha, my father, and many others who came to Australia after the war, felt that it was important to both recreate and adapt SKIF to a new land and new times. This was not to be the SKIF of Poland, it was to be the SKIF of Australia, but with very much the same spirit, ideology, and essence as SKIF has always had. So we've been going for 70 years now. A lot of families are now in their third generation of SKIFisten. My children no less than others, Simcha Burstin's grandchildren no less than others. And SKIF now runs camps three times a year, meets every Sunday. Lots of kids go through it. They have fun. They learn about the world. They learn about Yiddishkeit. They learn about how to make the world a better place and what they can do to contribute to that. Lots of community leaders have come out of SKIF in many organisations, Jewish Welfare Society, Jewish Care, Jewish schools, Kadimah, other cultural institutions. And, of course, In One Voice, the leading Jewish festival in Australia, in the Southern Hemisphere, is a joint venture of SKIF and the Kadimah.
And you're heavily involved with the Bund.
I'm vice president of the Bund, but the Bund and SKIF are father and son, mother and daughter. They are intimately related organisations. Mm-hmm. And we celebrate the work that SKIF does and shep nachas from our children and our grandchildren.
And it's a socialist leftist group, isn't it? A
bit? That's correct. Yep. Absolutely. Proudly so. Our aim is to make the world more just, more equal, more fair, more free.
Mm. And there's also the other group which overhangs the whole lot is the Kadimah, which is the...
No, Henry. The Kadimah is a completely separate organisation. Completely separate organisation. There are lots of people who are involved in both organisations. Both organisations are strong supporters of Yiddish and Yiddish culture, and in that sense the two organisations have similarities which have them travel paths together, so... In One Voice is a great example where the two organisations do work together. But the Kadimah is a cultural organisation, the Bund is a political and cultural organisation, and they're quite separate institutions with many things in common.
And the other part is the Sholem Aleichem College, which is another integral part of the whole shtick that you're running there.
Well, again, Sholem Aleichem is a separate organisation. It has its own ideology, its own committee, its own people. And again, because of the strong Yiddish and secular connection, there's a lot of overlap of people there, and they do run activities together with us, and we support them where we can. But the organisations do all stand on their own two feet.
Right. Well, we're today celebrating, or next month, according to Moshe Goldberg, because how this all came about was that I saw an article in Plus61J, which was emailed to me last week on Wednesday, and I sent a message to Moshe Goldberg, because I knew he actually wrote the article saying, come on the shtick and talk about it, because I remember him from the old days. And apparently he passed away on Sunday, very sadly. I'd like to actually dedicate this particular episode to the memory of Moshe Goldberg, because he was part of the legend of SKIF and the Bund and Kadimah.
Moshe was certainly one of the formative people that I remember from my very, very early days at SKIF, universally known within our circles as Spud. Mm-hmm. And he talks about that in the article you've mentioned.
Yeah.
And I think Spud's last camp as Vorsitzer's commandant, leader of the camp, my first camp. So I have some memories of him running camp and his warmth, enthusiasm, energy. And certainly got to know him, you know, in the subsequent years as well. I don't know if anybody's ever said a bad word about Moshe. And the article he writes is a beautiful, heartfelt tribute to the influence that SKIF had on him, and no less the influence that SKIF, that he had on SKIF for many, many years.
Yeah, well, there were many luminaries that came out of SKIF camp, including Michael Gawenda and the Zabel brothers. And there were so many that we know and treasure in our community. But I'd like to send our sincere condolences to the family. And we can't really say much more except to wish them long life. And I'd like to thank you very much for coming on and illuminating me, because there's so many arms and tributaries to the SKIF family that we're learning every day.
Thank you very much, Henry. And if we're going to finish a SKIF conversation, we have to finish with the SKIF motto, Chaverschaft.
Chaverschaft, which means friendship.
Absolutely.
That's what it's all about. Yeah, I know we didn't speak any Yiddish, mit reden später. Which means we'll speak later. And we're going out with a little clip from In One Voice, which was last year. This year, unfortunately, we didn't have a In One Voice, but last year it was really an amazing event, a beautiful day. Mit sich sehen, sei gesund.
Not zum gesund.
Not zum gesund. You're a doctor already. Sholem Aleichem.
Aleichem Sholem, sei gesund.
Shalom Yid. Shalom Dag.